All right. Well, I should be live. Should be live, and I am checking to see that this is indeed functioning. And it does appear to be functioning. So that is extremely exciting, given as I have not streamed since June, probably. Something really terrifyingly long like that. And tonight is indeed completely improvised, caused by chatting with some friends on Discord. And so we are going to be doing this completely on the fly. It is the version of Where in the USA, is Carmen Sandiego that I grew up with, and that is not the original version. It is the CD-rom version, I think from around 1996. So that is going to be different than what some people are used to seeing for Where in the USA is Carmen Sandiego, because I think there's like four different freaking versions of it. And I do intend to play the original at some point, but tonight I am going in for the nostalgia of what I personally played myself. So I am just going to sit here for a short amount of time and just wait for a little bit of confirmation that other people are seeing, hearing, etc. ing me. And then I am going to get going on the game itself and hopefully have a fun time hanging out with folks. All right, Light says hi. Hi, you nerd. I'm loud and nerdy. Awesome. So, does that mean that my volume is too loud, or is this just a general comment about me being myself? I did try to boost my microphone levels a little bit from my previous streams because I know that my voice mic can get a little bit quiet. So, I'm trying to push this without getting too much in the way of microphone sound distortion from a mic gain. It's a pain in the butt. Comment about you being yourself and also joke on loud and clear. All right, awesome. I will get that as a green light. That is good to hear. I am always so freaking paranoid about audio or video cutting out on me because for some strange freaking reason, these things go wrong all the freaking time whenever I stream. Okay, here we go. So, here we are. Very, Streamying. You're a little. You're a. I said Lello. You're a yellow light. Yes, whatever. You are a light of doom. And that is all that matters. Alrighty. So here we go. I'm gonna do a quick check. And I think we are good to start. It's just gonna be the frickin' credit opening Mabopi anyway for the first minute. So. Might as well just watch the awesome credit Mabopi thingy for a minute. Have you played any of the Carmen Sandiego games of Doom? Because I've definitely played several. This is the one that I played the most as a kid. This one. The CD-ROM version of the USA one. Here we go. Woohoo! Oh, all these sexy graphics. The sexiest. Actually, because it's Carmen Sandiego, it is sexy, and I'm allowed to say that because this Carmen is good. See, and I never got around to the cartoon. I know that Jaya's gotten through the cartoon. Lots of folks have. I didn't. I didn't know about the cartoon, but I knew about the games. And so, I've done several of the games. Pretty sure I've done the space one. Yeah. She is so sexy. And the fact that the new Netflix version of them, they just sort of like childized her and like took away the sex appeal and took away the like badass villain approach thing, it annoys me. Like, you can do that with literally any other character and
Time to
it's
contact
fine.
my collection of crooked
But this is Carmen,
compadres.
right here. The
My
bold and
coast-to-coast
proud.
crime spree is about to begin. I've filched the world's finest artifacts. And now, America's greatest treasure. will soon be in the hands of Carmen Sandiego.
See? She knows she's sexy. She likes being sexy. She knows she's a villain, and she likes being a villain. That's the best possible scenario of all time. Like, come on. I'm going to start completely from new. I honestly don't know, even know if the last one's saved. I did not figure out the save function before I cut out of this. So we're going to do... All right, what's my name? You get to pick my freaking name. Pick my name. I'm going to regret this. Yeah. Thank you! Thank you! See? Thank you. No, she is absolutely, like, oh my gosh, she is glorious. I have wanted to cosplay her because, yum. And just that power, that confidence, that stride, that tallness, that everything. Name, butt fart. And since you're the only one online right now, I guess I have to deal with it. Surprised that Fury and Jaya haven't said a hallo yet, but you know what? I have made it clear in the Discord, and if they want to stop by, they can stop by. If they don't want to stop by, there ain't nothing wrong with them not stopping by neither. So, butt fart, it is. Yes! See? Yes! Thank you! Thank you! Okay, first of all, that's a compliment, and also just, like, that red hat in trench coat and the... yes! I'm sorry, she's just... Yes! I love her! So, yes, yes, this is just the aura. You don't take away the aura of Carmen Sandiego. Like, that's the entire point of her, is to have that aura. So, yeah, I got through, like, the first two episodes of the next Netflix new one, but I just want to watch the old stuff. I want to play the old stuff. I want to relish my villains. Let me keep my villains. Okay, yep. Okay, so I guess it is butt fart. It's all hot and styling. Yes, see? Thank you. They knew exactly what they were doing. This is exactly it. Okay, so butt fart it is. Why not? Agent butt fart. There's worse names.
Hello, and welcome to Acme. I'm the chief. But don't just think of me as your boss. Think of me as your co-worker and your boss. All of us here at Acme have the same job, tracking down thieves. Ultimately, we're after the number one thief of all time, Carmen Sandiego. Here's how we work. When you report for duty, I assign you a case. You go to the scene of the crime and try to figure out where the crook went with the loot. Then the chase is on. Crooks always leave a trail, and anyone you meet might be a witness. So, always ask questions. When you finally close in on the thief,
not sure that's how real investigation
works. To make the arrest. You can't do that without a warrant. So, fill in your CompuCrook to create a profile of the thief. There's a lot more to this job, but you'll have to learn as you go, because time waits for no crime. Ready to tackle your first case?
Time waits for no one. I've got a song stuck in my head. Okay. Yes, I want a new case. Although exploring is cool. I don't know. Should we I feel like I should just go into the case and we can just run off to the wrong state several times. It's a... Shh! Let me criticize! Alright, case time, I guess. Instead of just exploring around... otherwise I would just jump straight to the reason that I got excited when I was playing earlier, and we're sure to get to that without any issues otherwise. Okay.
The state of Indiana is in a state of panic, and here's why. Someone stole the checkered flag from the Indy 500. The nation's most famous auto race will never finish if you don't collar the crook who captured the flag. Report to Indianapolis right away, and good luck, Gumshoe.
Beethoven! See? This is folk music too. I'm starting on a different case than I got last time, and it's already folk music again. No, the glasses absolutely help me look better. And we get to see the race cars. I mean, this is banjo and fiddle all the way. Stature low without low self-esteem. Tips for the tiny. So my suspect is short. Cool. See, ain't this music like way too rockin' it for a video game like this? Although their wordplay is always too good for the video game too. And then we might as well just go to this little thingy where it's like a little quiz center of doom. And it's actually pretty cool. Blah, 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 blah. And then you get to say true or false. Tips for the tiny, I need this. I love you. And then I have not figured out a way how to get this better except to like completely do that. Last winter in Indiana got its name because it had a habit of disappearing. Dude, I don't remember a thing about the music of this game. Like, when I went there, and the first location I was in, before I started streaming was New Hampshire, and I heard, like, sort of like an old Scotch-Irish sort of song. I was like, whoa, I do not freaking remember this. And then when I got to North Dakota, and it was the Country Gentleman, and I was like, what? I do not remember this. Dude, no, I don't remember any of this. I don't remember the music. The music completely went out the Haddock Kid ear. And it is all new to me. And now as a folk music music nut, I'm just like, what the oh my gosh. So yeah, you can just keep on getting quiz questions of doom. Farm race or giant threshing machines. Yes, that's how it goes. I would totally watch that though. Come on guys, tractor races. Remember that Tumblr post where it's like about the guy who went to the tractor race all dressed up like in the most stereotypically gay clothes ever, and this one guy was grumbling about it, and he's like complaining about like, what do you think freedom means, Earl, or whatever it is. Yeah. Oh, come on. You are just being a butt fart to me about this. Yeah, this does not count. I was talking to you about musical influences that actually influenced me last night. This did not influence me last night. What do you think freedom means, Earl? One of my favorite lines ever. Yep. Yep, anyway, so that's the cool little quizzes of doom. This does not... Get out! There's lots of video games where I remember the music too, like the Commander Keen music. I remember that! That's different. But see, anyway, here's a cool little shit, is that you can go and you can pick out different states of doom. And it's actually really informative, and I'm impressed at the level of informativeness. As a kid, I doubt I spent any time on this page. I was just like, it was so boring. But now I'm just like, oh, this is cool. So here, look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Famous people. It's alphabetical. Whoosh. Whooshy, 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 whoosh. See? 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 Earl Scruggs! Born in Cleveland County, musician revolutionized bluegrass music with his 5-string banjo playing. See? Earl! And because this is in a video game from the 1990s, he was still alive when this was made, which is sort of fascinating to think about. See? Oh, shut! Leave! Butt! Fart! Meh! Shut up. But isn't that awesome? Look, there's Earl! Ah! Okay, now the real question is, do they have Bill Monroe in Kentucky? They better... Let's... Oh, whoops, wrong button. Come on. Bill. 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 Let's cheer for Bill. 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 Kentucky. Blue moon of Kentucky. keep on shining. Okay, he wrote Blue Moon of Kentucky, which is their state song. There is a chance of Bill being in here. There's a chance. Let's see. There's a chance. I'm not really convinced that he's going to be in here, but, you know, maybe. It's a very maybe. Yep, nope, he's not. So, yeah. I did notice in Tennessee there were some Grand Ole Opry stars in there. Yep, okay, fine, you freaking nerd. Hey, here's your boyfriend, Harlan Sanders. Kentucky Colonel Chicken, Kentucky Fried Chicken. There's your boyfriend. Aww, there he is. Okay, Tennessee. There were some names I definitely recognized in Tennessee that I glanced at. I passed it. Okay. See? Roy Acuff. I thought that was so cool. I'm like, oh, look, Grand Ole Opry, you know? Like, all this stuff means things to me. I don't know, as a kid, that I would recognize any of the words that they're saying in that little blurb. Roy Acuff, born near Maynardsville, country music star, singer, bandleader, member of the Grand Ole Opry since 1938, elected to the Country Music Hall of Fame in 1962. Woohoo! Eddie Arnold. That's so weird in this video game. Eddie Arnold was still alive at the time. Born in Hendersonville. Like, everybody lives in Nashville. Okay. Singer known as the Tennessee Plowboy, one of the most successful singers in Nashville's history, elected to the Country Music Hall of Fame in 1966. Chet Atkins! Woohoo! Producer and guitarist, one of the creators of the Nashville Sound, named Instrumentalist of the Year 8 times. Oh, come on! Get a move. Leave. I hate you. Shut up. Come on, this is so freaking cool that we've got this many country musicians being mentioned in, like, a little kid's video game. Well, not a little kid's, but, you know. David Crockett, King of the Wild Frontier. Who else is in here? Oh, interesting. William Handy, bandleader, solo cornetist, composer, music publisher, wrote the first blues song on Beale Street in Memphis. His best known song is Saint. Oh, that's a good one. All others include Beale Street Blues, Memphis Blues, Mississippi Blues, and Harlem Blues. Oh, cool. That's spiffy. Hi! Oh my gosh, dude, I'm gonna distract you so much from your essay. It's great to hang out with you, though. Oh! Ooh! Silas! That's a good thing. Yes, we have to look for Jack London. See, isn't this almost more fun now that you're an adult and you, like, know these names? Loretta Lynn! Songwriter, singer, Grand Ole Opry star, the first woman named Entertainer of the Year by the Country Music Association in 1972. Dolly Parton! Aww. Born in, okay. Singer-songwriter, movie and television star, owner of Dollywood Family Theme Park in Pigeon Forge. Minnie Pearl! Woo-woo-woo! Born Sarah Ophelia Colley Cannon in Centerville, comedian, star of the Grand Ole Opry, spokesperson and goodwill ambassador for Tennessee, named to Country Music Hall of Fame in 1972. She's really interesting. She is really interesting, and I've been meaning to get her biography. I've been listening to the audio tapes that she told her biographer while they were preparing their biography, and oh my gosh, it is so interesting. She just has this wonderful, calm eloquence to her as she goes through all these tiny details of all the memories that she has, and just splendid memories, too. Hey, you know Minnie Pearl? Boom! Yes! No, she's awesome. She's cool. And there's some really encouraging things learning about her. for instance, like, you know, I think about all these people becoming famous in their 20s, and she was talking about, you know, she was in her late 20s starting to do stuff on the Grand Ole Opry, but how she felt like she was failing, really wasn't doing good, wasn't hitting her stride. And it's just a really good point about, you know, gaining experience over time. Like, you know, she might have started her well-known role in her 20s, but she sure was not kicking it out of the ballpark at that time. Yeah, that's true. I would have mentioned her. There's a song book that I might be buying. Well, I guess it's a picture book, since she doesn't really do songs as much. There's a book, a souvenir book of Minnie Pearl that's on sale on eBay that I'm probably going to pick up. The reason is that there's signatures on it. And they're not Minnie Pearl signatures, but it's Kitty Wells and Johnny and Jack. And I thought that was pretty cool. Like, wow, that's all three of those. Yeah, okay. Anyway, Carl Perkins, born in Jackson, rock and roll singer and songwriter, composed Blue Suede Shoes, recorded for the original Sun Records in Memphis. Elvis! Singer, actor, lived at Graceland in Memphis, fused rhythm and blues with country and western music styles to become the king of rock and roll, one of the most popular entertainers of the second half of the 20th century. Yep. So many musicians. I'm just going through folks I know. AKA the musicians. Oh, Bessie. Yep. Bessie Smith. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. Oprah. Right. Okay. Anyway, California, we were looking for Jack London. Okay, let's see who y'all got. Hey! Look at here! John Griffith Jack London! Born in San Francisco, novelist and short story writer, among his most famous works are the collection of tales, the 1897 Klondike Gold Rush, called The Sun and the Wolf, yep, and his novel, Call of the Wild. Look at that! There's your boy! Woohoo! That's pretty spiffy. Good call that Jack London could be there. He-Man! Sorry. Okay, anyway, is there anybody else we need to look up? Because this is fun. It is strangely fun to see who they do pick. I've already looked through Colorado's, of course. Nothing too shocking. Black Kettle for the Sand Creek Massacre. Yeah, that's a pretty big name. Yep, Unsinkable Molly Brown. Not surprised she made it. John Elway. That one cracked my ass off. That John Elway got in there. Yeah, no, the John threw me. The John did throw me for Jack London. Okay. I do appreciate that they're bringing in Native American and other people important to histories, too. Yep, of course, Zebulon Pike for Pike's Peak. Yep, uh-huh. Paul Whiteman, I did not realize until I read that it was born in Denver. So, yeah, that was fun. Oh, I wonder if Jimmy... Oh, wait. No, it's freaking. Yep. Let's see if I'm right. Yep, I knew it. Hank Williams in Alabama. Yeah, no, like this is, again, this is like almost more exciting as an adult, isn't this? Wait, you saw Johnny Appleseed? Was that in? Do you remember what state you saw that in? I was getting so excited about Hank Williams being here. Born near Georgiana, country and western singer and composer, helped popularize country music, popular performer at the Grand Ole Opry, composed more than 125 songs, including his famous Cold, Cold Heart. Yep. Yep, I figured Hank Williams would be in there. MLK. The sights is really cool. Like, the thing with the sights is I could actually use the sights as, like, a way to, tour a location. Okay, damn. Well, we'll have to find Johnny Appleseed sometime. Because it's like, you know, there's lots of things down here that's listing as notable places to go in Colorado, and I haven't been to all these. But I know about lots of them. Like, you know, I know about Chimney Rock and the National Monument. Cripple Creek, I was entertained, got mentioned on there. They just don't mention the gambling part of it for a kid's game, right? Durango and Silverton Narrow. Yeah, I went to Durango when I was 4. Don't remember it. Yep, yep. See, like, all this stuff is stuff I could go to. It would be cool. Garden of the Gods! Okay, that is a cool place. Mesa Verde, I keep intending to go there. Pikes Peak, I do not want to climb that. Maybe another 14er. Rocky Mountain National Park, go there a lot. The Capitol Telluride, I'm sure Tyr would be happy that Telluride's on there. Oh, hey, thank you, Jaya. Yeah, it's true. We can just quickly hop between all the states until we find Appleseed. Oh, I love her. Okay, anyway, until we find Appleseed. Appleseed. Benjamin Banneker, I did a book report on him one time in the 5th grade. Johnny Appleseed, Indiana. Born John Chapman, planter, walked through Ohio, Indiana, and Illinois territories, planting apple seeds as he walked, became a frontier and American folk legend. There you are! Alright! Stellar stuff! Cool. Is there anybody else that we need to look up while we're here and being distracted on the area that no children would be distracted in for 20 minutes at the age of 8? Okay. So, yeah. Oh. Huh. That's how you quit. Cool. Yeah, no, there's a lot of fun stuff here, isn't there? There's, like, legitimately fun stuff. Okay, now let's try to actually, like, find the suspect. Hey, hey. Hot, tall person.
Nice to see you. Her tresses look like tar.
Alright, black hair.
She said that, alphabetically speaking, she was headed for the number one state.
Thank you.
Y'all come back now.
Very southern. Hey, dude.
Hey there!
Did any of y'all have those, like, CD-ROM encyclopedias where, it was like a gamified encyclopedia for kids and you clicked things because it wasn't really an internet world yet. Man, I had so much fun with those things.
She's taller than a fire hydrant, but not by much.
So she's short and has black hair.
She headed off for state number 22, a land once owned by the Spanish, French, and even British too. Until next time.
Dude.
Hello! On a scale of 1 to 10, she'd weigh in at a 5.
Okay, medium weight.
She was picking her way down to the heart of Dixie because she didn't cotton to the weather around here.
Har, har, har.
Goodbye.
And do you all notice that my tank starts falling lower and lower the more questions I ask? Yeah, it's great. All right, so... short. Average. Okay. Heart of Dixie. And see, here's the cool thing that I never did as a kid that now I'm smart enough to find. Look. Ta-da! Guesswork ended. Yep. Here we go. Alabama. We can do more quiz games, but let's go to the next location. Yep, Alabama, Florida. Oop. This is totally what Beethoven planned his music to be used for.
I'd recognize that bag of bolts anywhere. It's Robo-Crook. He must be on a mechanical mission for Carmen.
Had a dream the other night when everything was still. Thought I saw the Georgia Bell coming down the hill.
Born in Georgia, born out of stem. Born in Georgia, where my life will win.
Paying attention to this music, y'all? This is Country Gentleman again. I recognize the harmonies. So going down to Georgia, Country Gentleman. I'm looking it up.
Going to Atlanta, just to look around. Things don't suit me if I'm in the town.
Born in Georgia, born out of Stanley.
No, 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 this is the Stanley Brothers. No, that's the Stanleys. That's the Stanleys! That's why it's a good banjo! No, going down to Georgia, going down to... That's... How did I miss Ralph's voice up at the top? To Georgia, going down to town... Yep, I caught it. Oh my gosh, guys. Oh. My gosh! This is the fucking Stanley Brothers. Like, this is as good of bluegrass music as you possibly can get. Like, this is one of the big three for people who aren't familiar with the bluegrass world. The big three of first generation bluegrass. Bill Monroe, Flatten Scruggs, and the Stanley Brothers. Oh my gosh. I cannot believe. And Ralph Stanley, that wonderful banjo you're hearing. Mmm, yum. He has really good banjo. I love his banjo work. It is a delectable thing. I haven't showed you this song. I'm not familiar with this song, which is why I accidentally got caught off guard for a second. But there's no mistaking it because Ralph has a very, very distinct tenor sound. He sings like he has coal in his voice. It's this wonderful sound. But lots of their songs sound pretty similar, let's be real. So, yeah, I'm not surprised it rings a bell of familiarity to you. Oh my... Holy mother of balls! This game has the Stanley Brothers in it! I am gonna freaking die! Okay, wow, I swear I am playing a game instead of just crying about banjos. Oh my gosh, though. I'm still laughing at that. Oh my gosh, I'm screaming, though. Okay, look for hints on the floor. For all your middling waist needs. Right.
Going to Atlanta, just
out, Silas. Okay, I know this is why I started streaming this. And I've already done 30 minutes of just, oh my gosh, this is terrible. This is terrible. Well, we got distracted with the info. Hey, tall person.
Greetings.
I'm going to be distracted by the music. I'm not going to pay attention to the clues because I'm going to be sitting here being like, holy shit, it's my Stanley boys. I love my boys.
Her height is like a child's attention span.
And mine, apparently.
I've heard the old saying, united we stand, divided we fall, before, and never knew it was a state motto. Ta-ta.
Okay, united we fall. United we stand. Alright, Kentucky! Cool. We're going to Kentucky next! Should I talk to more folks? The longer I talk to people, the more I get to listen to Ralph and Carter.
How are you?
I'm doing good. I know where I'm going, but can you tell me, like, what she's wearing?
Her hair was the color of coffee, without any cream. Bon voyage.
Have I talked to Tall Dude yet?
Good to see you. Her hair made me think of octopus ink. Y'all come back, yeah?
Thanks, dude. I always loved seeing these dudes. How's my suspect? Have I changed anything? Nope, I'm not gotten anything new. Yeah, I don't have the accessory yet, which I asked for them, but I can't ask any more folks. I've gotten all the folks. Oh my gosh, guys, this was so worth streaming just because of my excitement for hearing the Stanleys. And I'm forever gonna be mortified that I didn't immediately hear Ralph's voice. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy! Oh, I have to leave my boys. Okay. There's gonna be more good music. Bill Monroe! Bill! Come on, Blue Moon of Kentucky!
If you want to learn more about a location, try calling up one of the Acme good guides, who can give you a tour. If you do, you can call back that good guide later to help check over your warrant.
So it's still bluegrass. No, I don't know this song. I wonder if they have like a credits anywhere where they list off all the songs, because wow, the soundtrack to this is way too good. You'll see what I mean, right? This is like all right up my alley. So bizarre. Hey, you.
My, what a pleasant surprise. I looked just in time to see her don a cap and depart.
Got a cap. We got the accessory. Thank you.
She said she was late for a date in the 39th state. It was nice visiting with you.
Okay, wearing a hat. What other awesome things can you wear? Okay, so it's a hat. Yeah, as a kid, I like never heard this stuff. So the 39th state. Wonder if you can get it just by typing 39th. North Dakota? Well, this is a good excuse to go to the country gentleman. We're going anyway. Yeah, but we're going to North Dakota because country gentleman, and then I'll issue the warrant. Thanks for telling me. Country gentleman first, though. They're more important than the criminal. See? bluegrass again. Isn't that just bad shit, y'all? It's fun to see and look around every location. And there's extra proof that there's a hat.
Come up here, my little Bessie. Come up here and live with me.
Isn't this so cool? This absolutely threw me for a loop so much that I had to run into Discord. This is the reason I ran to Discord. Alright, issue a warrant. There we go. And then it's just, what, a matter of finding her? Do more quiz questions. I don't remember. Yeah, that's really. Oh, I was not looking at the things. Maybe you should actually read it. Fish don't have hands, this is true. You know I'm misreading you intentionally. Butt fart. Yep, that tracks. And now it can do its little thingy.
Nice to see you here. She was leaving for a state named in honor of the French king, Louis the 14th.
It's clearly West Virginia.
So long for now.
Getting tight, Gumshoe. We heard that Carmen's on her way to pick up the loot from your suspect. If you don't make a bust soon, it'll be too late to make it at all. Good luck.
All right, yep, there's the sign to try to find her. That's her. Found her.
Howdy.
See? Yep. Here we go. Thanks to Rookie Buttfart for the return of the...
I guess the writing's on the wall. I hope I get letters in jail.
Darn light. Rookie Buttfart.
I love to read good news about my agent. Nice work. Correspondent is old news now, thanks to you. We searched that miscreant's clothing and found a hidden pocket with a note inside. It reads... Dear Robo Crook, soon we'll pull off the perfect theft. A scheme of grand design. I'm faxing it to you for further reference. Unfortunately, another heist just happened. Will you take the case?
Yes. We need to go to Colorado at least some point, though, just for shits and giggles.
There's been a time crime in Connecticut. All the hour hands from all the clocks at the American Clock and Watch Museum are gone. The minutes are ticking by, but no one knows the hours until you get yourself there and get on the case. Good luck, Gumshoe.
Whoever they hired for the chief, you could not have picked a better actress. There's just such a vibe about her. Huh. More jazzy now, huh? You are tall. Alright. Watch. Of course the person who stole the watch stuff is wearing a watch!
Greetings! Time after time, she glanced at her timepiece. She took the middle ground to Ashland in Lexington, home of the great compromiser, Henry Clay.
Pretty cool.
Until we meet again.
How you doing?
You are so tall.
Be careful. She probably outweighs you 10 to 1.
All right, so tall. I mean, blah. On the heavier side. That's wrong dimensions. I swear I know the difference between up and down.
Honest! She proclaimed she was off to see where Abe Lincoln was born. And it wasn't Illinois. See ya!
It really sort of trips the brain about, like, shoot, what do I remember or not?
She looks like she buys her clothes at the hefty lady shop. She packed socks for a trip to Fort Knox to get a gander at the gold guarded there. Bye-bye.
Alright. Lady... Watch. Alright, so we're talking about Fort Knox? Pretty damn sure, I know, but we're being extra careful because we're stupid. Yep.
Welcome to this neck of the woods. I saw her continually checking the time. She choked off for Somerset to ride the Big South Fork Railroad past some coal mining camps.
It'd be more fun to do this without, like, checking anything and just see how terrible I am at my own knowledge of the place I live in. I feel like I would get a lot of this off, because I do not remember things at all. So you guys might remember more than me. But Kentucky is where we're gonna go. And this is entirely because of bluegrass that I recognize the places they referenced.
Meow, meow, meow.
know that cat. Her name is Carmine. Her master is Carmen, and she smells like crime. You must be closing in.
Just vibe into the music. Hi, grumpy dude.
Salutation.
And then suddenly you're friendly. No. But that's not gonna stop me. I know just where I'm bound. And if you ever look for me, know where I'll be found. If you ever look for me, you know where I'll be found. It can't be. Oh my gosh, it can't be. I'm re-listening to the lyrics and looking up. I think I know who this is, and if it is, I am going to shit a brick. I know. If you ever look for me, you know where I'll be found. I'm looking at I know. No, I don't know the song. I know the voice, but I'm hesitant because it's his young voice. I'm checking what's the Come on, search, find the name of the song. Yep. Yep. The sign on the highway says it's 30 miles to go. Just as well 10,000 with freezing rain with snow. Oh, but that's not gonna stop me. I know just where I'm bound. And if you ever look for me, know where I'll be found. I'm trying to get the name of the song. Come on, internet. Anyway, this is Del McCurry. I'm pretty sure that's Del. The Dixie Pals. It's the singing style. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I couldn't find the song. I'll have to research this one later, but my ear is saying this is Del. Yeah. 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 It's his right vocal timbre and the right singing technique. He sounds different when he's young, so I wanted to double check before I said my suspicion, but I can't find the song, but I'm thinking this is Del McCurry. I can't believe that this frickin' video game is turning into me playing Identify the Bluegrass Singer! No, that's totally Del. That's totally fucking Del. Fucking hell. I'm dead. Okay, anyway. Sorry, dude. I was talking to you.
There's nothing you can say about her height except that it's ordinary.
Medium height, okay.
That sap went running off to the state famous for its
maple syrup! Okay, that helps.
May the road rise to meet you.
I cannot... Guys, I'm absolutely dying. I am absolutely dying from this game. I know I'm playing it slow, but I'm just dying it from the music. Like, how is this even possible?
How you doing? Her head was covered with the gold of autumn leaves.
Gold.
She said she had the green light to head for the Green Mountain State. See ya.
Guys, I am absolutely dying. How is this possible? I am having a life crisis.
Nice to see you around these parts.
I am having a life crisis that, like, all of my bluegrass heroes that I would learn about in my late 20s, I heard as a child in these video games. Like, of all places to have been exposed to them, why was it this? I mean, I'm sure I probably heard them through, like, a Prairie Home Companion too, but I knew about that already. But Carmen Sandiego? Like, why, where did you guys get, like, why did you go all out on the bluegrass? Like, did you get, like, a good bluegrass package deal? Was the person who was doing the sound for this game, like, I love bluegrass. Like, why is there so much bluegrass?
She put her foot in her mouth and was a towhead to boot. She was off to that state that takes its name from two French words, Bert and Mont.
I have no idea which state that is.
Don't be a stranger.
No, I want to be as strange as possible. I am absolutely dying. I should almost make a fucking compilation fucking video of... just my reactions to the freaking music. Like, just make a compilation video of my reactions because this is ridiculous.
I'll sing you a song that's not very long about young men who wouldn't hoe corn. The reason why no one can tell, for this young man was always well.
This was the song that I started with when I first started playing. I didn't realize I actually know this song. I know a bluegrass variation of this song. Okay, I guess I can issue the warrant, right? Because they said, yeah, we got everything. We got everything. I like this dude.
How can I help you?
Nice neck.
She's rushing to the treasure state. Goodbye for now.
Hey, y'all want to do this without, like, looking anything up and just see how bad we are?
Welcome to this neck of the woods. She went south from Alberta Province to see the falling waters of the Missouri's Great Falls.
Okay, so very north.
Come back soon.
Nice to see a friendly face.
You have a very friendly face too. Look at that beard. Respect.
Between Boise, Idaho and her destination state's capital are some very rocky mountains.
Montana.
I'm glad our paths crossed.
Man, you are cute.
Nice to see you here. She's watching cattle graze near Missoula.
I like how all of the people that we talk to know where this, like, random criminal is. Okay. Oh, nice. They went all sneaky and did all those three. But the Rocky Mountains are in Montana!
Thank you.
Yep. Don't you just love 90s animation, y'all?
Please gather all my last handful.
Oh, whoops. Okay, so she's medium height, blonde. Nope, I can't find her yet. After you buried me deep in the tomb, tell him these things are what ruined his brother, and never depart with the last fatal hand, but carry it always just as a reminder, if ere he should come to this wild cattle land. I don't know this song, but if it was someone like Vernon Dahlier, I would blow a gasket.
How can I help you? I have a sinking feeling she's barely keeping her head above water at the Norfolk shipyards.
You said Norfolk. I did not. Is that how you say it?
Goodbye for now.
This is nice.
Pleasure to make your acquaintance.
It's definitely old. The music.
I cannot tell a lie, she said. I'm burning to visit Mount Vernon and see George Washington's birthplace.
Okay. That...
Do come again.
Yep, I know. Okay. I am not that stupid. I do know that one.
Howdy. Keep a lookout. I suspect she's up to something devilishly grand southwest of Maryland. Bye now.
Okay. Of course, if I got this wrong, everyone would give me shit for not knowing where George Washington lived. Did I almost say Josh Washington? I got the SH in early. Yeah! We're gonna talk about our first president, Josh! Alright, thief time!
We just got a hot tip. The crook is meeting Carmen soon to deliver the stolen goods. You need to make the bust before that happens. Good luck. Be careful and be quick.
Be quick, you say, as you call me. Joshington! Joshington, who wears jorts. It's the jort AU. This is good music. Ooh, we got some guitar work in here. No, we're gonna lose a criminal because we're just gonna be jamming out to this awesome as fuck music, y'all. Okay. Oh man, y'all. I really want to see a list of all the tracks on this. This is so good. Ah! Clawhammer banjo! Okay, so medium height with a watch. That's you. That's the person. Pretty darn sure. Yep. Yep. Yeah, that's her. Or is that considered tall or is that medium? No, that's tall. That's medium.
Glad to make your acquaintance.
Carmen! Why is Carmen Sandiego a hub of bluegrass and old time and country music? Nope. It's hard to read butt fart on a page.
You may have me over a barrel, but I'm banking on Carmen to roll me back to freedom.
Why do I have to read butt fart on a page?
According to the papers, it's another good news day for Acme.
As a kid, I have caught the wrong person.
You solved the case, and now Ivana B. Rich is in very good.
Same, Giles.
Well,
same.
Done. That's the kind of news I like. You've got real.
Hey, y'all, mind
pump.
If I do a quick pee break, and then we'll actually like crack down on cases, and I'll try not to obsess over the music every 5 seconds.
Can I assign you to another case?
Okay, gonna do a quick pee time. Now you're seeing my secret in that I only put on clothes on the top half, and I have totally PJing it up like the usual Zoom conference stereotype. Yes! Let's do a new case! Also, we need to go to other areas, and I specifically need to find out if you have the Stanley Brothers, is, like, at least Flat and Scruggs somewhere else? Because if you have Flat and Scruggs somewhere, I'm gonna freaking die. Yeah, I would freaking die.
They're nibbling their nails in Nebraska, and here's why. Some chump chugged off with Chimney Rock. That flat-topped stone poking up out of the prairie was a major landmark. Without it, Nebraska looks flat as a pancake.
It Start is such a boring state.
Start tracking that rock robber gumshoe. Good luck.
Okay, I mock Nebraska, but that's because you're, like, required to where I live.
When we reached Dodge City, we drew our 4 months' pay. Times was better then, boys. It was a better day. The way we drank and gambled.
What's your link to? Oh, there's a playlist of all the songs used. Awesome. Thank you so much. I am going to save this. Linky, bink, dinky. And look it up later. I cannot. Yep, see, there it is. Ralph Stanley and the Clinch Mountain Boys going to Georgia. Ralph Stanley and the Clinch Mountain Boys. Is this after Carter died? Is that why I don't know it? That would explain it. Okay, I'm not gonna look. I'm not looking because I want to be surprised when I go to new locations. That is so cool that a fan has done that. Thank you so much for showing me that link. If you ever look for me song, the Del Mc... Right, the one, is it... Oh, shit, you're right. Is it the Del song? I'm not seeing his name on here, but we can look it up later. We need to look it up, and we need to figure it out, because that will haunt me too, like. Thank you for mentioning that, because that's going to haunt me too. Man, that sounded like him. Yeah, no, thank you, Jayo. You are a hero. I need a hero. Yeah, no, this is amazing.
If you ever see John Carter, you must
If you have ever seen John.
For he is the biggest cow thief that ever rode out there.
So, yeah.
If you want to hear him roar and spin the lively tale, when we went up the trail.
Yeah, because this is old time music right
now
here.
When we reached Dodge City, we drew our 4 months' pay.
Yeah.
Times was better then, boys. It was a better day. The way we drank and gambled and swung the girls around.
I just cannot believe. I just cannot believe. You found it?
If you ever see John Carter, you must.
Okay, so it says John Garner's Herd, which is the one we're currently listening to. Artist Slim Critchlow. Let's look up who Slim... I feel like I've seen this name on old records.
Now when we reached Dodge City, we drew our 4 months' pay. Times was better
Slim Critchlow. We're researching this dude right now.
The way we drank and gambled and swung the girls around.
Not seeing much on this dude. A guitarist? Okay, here we are. Slim Critchlow. A guitarist and singer of old-time cowboy songs, became known as a performer in the early 30s. My ear was saying this sounded like 30s music. That's amazing. It is. And in the early 1960s, he generated some acclaim in the folk revival. Yeah, no, my ear was like, this sounds like 1930s old time. Loneliness and depression. Holy mother of balls! He performed Loneliness and Depression when I was at his concert last month! Holy mother of fuckballs! I was at the... Oh my gosh! Me, I don't recognize... recognize this Del song. Del performed it in front of my face when I was in the third row this last month. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, Light. I am screaming. It was Del McCurry. Oh my fucking hell. Del McCurry is in my Carmen Sandiego video game. I'm so happy and going crazy. What, Light? What? I've lost it. Holy shit. I am so glad you told me this. I'm so glad I was right. I'm so glad my ear was like, that sounds like young Del. I cannot believe this. We are so bad at playing this game. This is not how adults play this game. Wow, okay. I cannot believe it. I cannot believe it. It was fucking Del McCurry. Okay, playing the game. Actually playing the game. Focus on game, not Del. Game, not Del.
Hiya. He was fair of hair.
All right, Blondie.
He was chanting a song about a new land that was once part of Mexico.
All right.
See you later.
We're going south, y'alls. Okay. Tall person. Hi.
How you doing? He looks awfully owlish in his wire rims.
All right, glasses.
Your thief departed to see a mirage in arid Albuquerque.
Albuquerque!
Okay. Come back anytime.
Shut the fuck up! Get out of my ass, Silas! Ah! Rude! Come on. Okay, in my fairness, he played 24 songs, and that was one of the few that I didn't recognize. And to be fair, this recording of Del is like, what, probably about 50 years apart from... Gosh, okay. So, dude, blonde, and glasses. Okay. And glasses. You have a stride. Hey, lady.
Glad to make your acquaintance.
I love how they, like, walk angry and then the second you touch them, they get happier. Because that's totally how talking to strangers works.
I bet no one ever makes jokes about his weight.
That could mean either really thin or really thick.
He had a burning desire to pilfer chili peppers in Las Cruces.
I mean, anyway, it's Albuquerque, New Mexico. We know it's New Mexico. Get the butt out, Silas. Get the butt out. Nebraska. What's going to be trivia on Nebraska? Let's make fun of Nebraska. Traveling west along the Oregon Trail, settlers saw small spurred elephants. I mean, no. Oh my gosh, I almost said something that would have been... Nope, not gonna say what went through my head. Man, this has like the best fucking soundtrack of any video game ever. Jaya knew exactly what went through my head. Yep. If you ever see John Carney, you know what? I'm just gonna say, yeah. Smash Mouth. Hey now, you're an all-star! Oh my gosh, all-star on banjo! Oh my gosh, all-star on banjo! Okay, so guys, I got a, next year's banjo course, we're gonna pick songs, and we can pick songs from like any genre and ever, and we put them and we make bluegrass covers of them, right? I should do All Star by Smash Mouth just to annoy people out, because I had no clue what I should pick, because I listen to just bluegrass. I don't know what to pick. Oh my gosh, we should do All Star with a rockin' banjo. Just tell me I'm right. You know the state? Yeah, I do. We're going to New Mexico.
We drank and gambled and swung the girls around, say, proud of Texas cowboy.
Okay. To take the town. I was just curious what sort of facts that they had about Nebraska. I could go to South Dakota. That'd be fun, but it's definitely New Mexico. I need a hero. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, line. Yes! Big brain moment. Alright, beautiful. Alright, no, I'm appreciative of the music now. Beautiful. Just a dance song. Medium weight. Okay. Oops. I don't know. Average. Everything needs to have a ghost in it. Ghost.
Please to make your acquaintance. He could hide under a table without crouching.
Short!
Make for Minnesota, then saunter south to where the tall corn grows.
Ew, gross! We're going to Iowa! Ew!
Cheers!
Gross! Why? Why does it have to be Iowa? It's disgusting. Okay, so we got everything, don't we? We got the whole dude. Middling weight. Glasses. Blondie. I think we got everything. I'm a little hesitant still. Well, hell, we got a lot of fuel.
Hey, how's it going? He should get a gold star for that hair.
All right, that confirmed that you are a blondie.
According to his story, he's headed just west of the Mississippi River,
it's
but
Iowa.
North of Missouri. See you later.
Okay, fine. I have no bias against Iowa. Where have you seen any bias against Iowa? You don't see me disliking Iowa. There's no dislike for Iowa. We're not going to Iowa. Also, do any of y'all mind if I eat? Because I have a brownie sitting right next to me and I want to eat. Again, yay 90s animation. Bluegrass again. With that very unique chord progression, I should know this song. It's a good subversion of expectations, that animation. Yeah, this chord progression right here. It's an old-time fiddle tune done with a bluegrass band. I don't know what song this is. I don't know the name of the song. Maybe I can look up. Yeah, I was wondering. Okay, yeah, that could be it. It's probably Bill Cheatham. Yeah, and it's on the list. They have Bill Cheatham on the list. Bill Cheatham has a very weird chord progression that would fit. I have played Bill Cheatham on banjo. Yeah, it's gotta be Bill Cheatham. Who's playing Bill Cheatham? Let's look it up. Jerry Douglas! Jerry Douglas! Is what the list says that Jaya sent us. Jerry Douglas! Okay! We'll just keep on going with the really big bluegrass names. I saw Jerry Douglas at the festival I was at, the bluegrass festival I was at. Jerry Douglas was one of the names I really wanted to go to because he's the best dobro picker who's alive today, in my personal opinion. He has a very sweet tone. It's just the sweetest tone that you can get out of a dobro. Where in the bluegrass is Carmen Sandiego? Jaya's right, that's what this should have been named. Oh my gosh. Light. Yeah, Bill Cheatham is a very popular song. It's a very popular song. It's a song I need to get better at playing. Because it's everywhere in bluegrass. If you do not play Bill Cheatham, shame on you, basically. We do play it in our bluegrass jams. We do play a version of Bill Cheatham, but I don't like the version of Bill Cheatham we have because it's a melodic banjo style thing. And I really like what Earl Scruggs does when he plays Bill Cheatham with Paul Warren. He only does accompaniment, but it's very, it's just nice meaty chords and really leaning into the weird minor chords that Bill Cheatham has. Okay. And I apologize for not recognizing the fiddle tune right away. Because, gosh, fiddle tunes all sound alike after a while. I'm sorry, they do. Okay, so let's talk to people.
How are things? He's easy to miss if you forget to look down. He gravely announced that he was headed toward Cape Hatteras, sometimes called the Graveyard of the Atlantic.
Okay, Atlantic. That's interesting.
Take care of yourself.
So, Graveyard of the Atlantic, so is it like down south? Let's try to do this without looking up shit. Make it hard. I'm gonna fucking die. This is Jerry Douglas. Yeah.
Greetings. He put on his frames and made a real spectacle of himself. He told me that nothing could be finer than to be in a state north of South Carolina.
North of South Carolina! I have no idea what that clue means! Okay, it's North Carolina. If you guys don't do Foggy Mountain Breakdown, I'm killing you. Just kidding.
Ta-ta.
Okay, if you don't do bluegrass in North Carolina, I am murdering you. North Carolina, y'all! While I eat a brownie. Old time. Claw hammer. With the guitar. Bum, butter. Okay, put the banjo down. Okay, I feel like I should look up what this song one is. Looking at the list to see if there's anything that's really sticking out for what this one probably is. That guitar. guitar is more modern than the banjo is. Old blind sow, she stole the Midlands, could possibly be it. Nope, they say that's Indiana. Is the playlist in order of the states? Oh fuck, I saw Banks of the Ohio is on here somewhere. Miller's Will. That's probably not it. Oh, whatever. I don't have to look up what this one is. You're gonna listen to Loneliness and Depression on repeat after this. Just imagine Del's handsome face and, you know, can't go wrong.
Pleasure to make your acquaintance. He looked quite brave, but his hair was yellow. He said he'd take the high road to an island state that is not just an island.
Rhode Island.
Do come again.
Welcome to this neck of the woods. He bragged that he could sail down the Blackstone, Pawtucket, and Seekonk rivers without ever changing course. Come back soon.
How you doing? He's filching the finance equations from an economics course at Brown University. See ya.
I'm pleased to make your acquaintance. I heard it through the grapevine that he's tasting wine at Saconnet Vineyards. Have a safe trip.
You're definitely East Coast.
Glad to make your acquaintance. He said he'd brook no delay. He'd wait nary a day before setting out to Narragansett Bay. Keep in touch.
Okay. See if that's an option. Yep, it's an option. Ta-da! Oh, we're gonna get the feed, y'all! Oh, that's Flight of the Bumblebee. Okay, so short, blonde glasses. That's gotta be him. Nice, open, non-shirt, dude. Yeah, it's a woman. I'm appreciating the accordion. Hey.
How can I help you?
You're cute. Oh, darn. I got the wrong one.
As they say in the press, whoops! You can't bust a crook if your warrant has a different crook's name on it. Next time, I'm sure you'll get it right. Are you ready for another assignment?
I think I issued
the
warrant.
You're going to the grain belt, Gumshoe. The cornfields of Iowa have lost their magic, 'cause someone filched the field of dreams. That mystical baseball diamond has vanished into thin air.
Who cares? It's Iowa.
The greatest ghosts have no place to play. You've got to get the field back and start the game again. Good luck.
Ugh. Of course we're going back to Iowa. This is my punishment for messing up. They just know. Nice dobro, though. Very nice dobro. I'll bet it's Jerry Nicholas again. Yep. Jaya thinking the same thing. I love you. Ugh, we're in Iowa. Who thought that Iowa was a good idea? Like, seriously, who thought that Iowa was a good idea? Okay, so we got glasses.
Ah!
That can float.
Hi, how are you? If he sat in a tall chair, his feet wouldn't touch the ground.
Okay, so not tall.
It was a fluke, but I overheard him say he'd go whale watching in Monterey Bay.
It was the 90s.
It was nice having you around.
I suspect it is the same crook, yeah.
Salutations! He's hard to miss in his horn-rimmed frames. He pointed to a spot on a map just west of Nevada and shouted, "Eureka! I found it!"
Light's excited.
May the road rise to meet you.
I should just start saying, "May the road rise to meet you," when I talk to folks.
How are things? His head was covered with the gold of autumn leaves. I hear he plans to plunder the rich soil of the San Joaquin Valley.
Yep, very Cali.
Take care of yourself.
I am very blonde. Yeah, it's the same bloke. But I'm gonna be extra careful since I got it wrong. Get out of the fucking Iowa! Nice song choice. Oh, you're cute. Hey, you.
Nice to meet you. I bet he can't reach the top shelf in his kitchen. He said he had no enemy in the state whose name means friendly.
Okay, I've got an idea already.
It's been fun.
How you doing?
He looks awfully owlish in his wire rims.
Hey, nice light. Oh, I see. I need to go down and get you. That's why I got it wrong.
I'm headed for the Lone Star State, he said with a twinkle in his eye.
Lone Star.
Come back anytime.
Yeah, I think I know where we're going.
Pleased to make your acquaintance. One look at those curls and you knew his parents had the Midas touch.
Yep, gold.
He's on a mission to visit the Alamo. Cheers!
Pleased to meet you. He reminded me of a good cheesecake. Not too heavy, not too light.
Yeah, because that's a normal way to describe people.
I hear he's posing as an old cow hand on the Rio Grande, alongside Mexican land.
Like, see, who talks like
that? All the best.
Okay. So, medium. Wait, short, weight, average. Yep, it's the same. Do we want to do quiz about Cali since we're in California? All right. If you think that I really didn't screw anything up, it is very issued. All right, let's see what Cali facts I can get wrong so that Light will get angry at me. Hey, no, maybe Light should be the one doing this and be like, "Ew, I messed up," or something, so we can mess you up. All right, so do you know this one? About Sarah Pardee Winchester, was a California popper who became governor? Come on, Ace. Supreme truth or brutal lie? Yeah, I'm agreeing with you. It sounds true. Oh, nope. Okay, that's fun. That's fun. That's more fun than what we were guessing. I like the truth. I want that to be true. I know it's not. All right, light, true or false? Reality. So we're doing reality. We got two votes for true. Beautiful. That is such a human thing, come to think of it. That a mistake ends up being, oh, let's make it a trend. Yeah, water running uphill. Don't happen.
To see you here. He could be a munchkin on Halloween. He's meeting a shady character in Parkersburg Park after dark. Nice meeting you.
This is just fun to chill and hang out with friends. Thanks, guys, for hanging out with me. I'm glad we're doing
this. Hey, how's it going? He should get a gold star for that hair of his.
It's the guy's eyebrow.
He said it was of grave importance that he see the country's tallest prehistoric burial mound at Grave Creek.
The fact that his glasses shoot up or drives me batty. You gotta stay? I don't gotta stay yet. I should know where Grave Creek is, but I don't.
See you later.
That guy reminds me of Aladdin with like the purple thing and then the chest exposed.
Hi there. Nice to see a new face.
He was diplomatic about his plans to visit the home of Senator Robert Byrd.
I read this when we were screwing around. Do I remember? No.
Sorry to see you go.
Thanks, bloke. Hey.
Hiya. In terms of height, he believes less is more. He said, where there's smoke, there's fire, and headed off to look for barbecue at Smoke Hole Caverns.
I've got a region.
See you later.
It's on the east.
Pleased to meet you. He was neither a plump lump nor a lean machine. I imagine he's having a peachy time at an orchard in the eastern panhandle. Good visiting with you.
And I do got him as average weight. I don't know where I'm going. gonna make it more fun. Oh, panhandle. Panhandle. They said panhandle. Okay. You know, we're gonna get a guess. There's no Georgia option. Ah. I did it. I remember that animation from a kid. Banks of Ohio. It's the banks of the Ohio. Won't you say that you'll be mine? That you'll be mine. Yep, of course we. Yeah. Who's the person who does Banks of the Ohio for this? Of course, we're, you know, ignoring the, murder verses. Okay, so the artist is Armstrong Twins. Cool. Cool. Welcome to West Virginia. Low without low self-esteem. Tis for the tiny by Pete Teat.
Hey! The sly guy announced that he knew a positively capital route to Juno.
Okay, we know where we're going.
His hair reminded me of ancient... Catch you later.
Juno, that's not hard. Oh, damn it, but we could go to Colorado! Aww. Guys, do you want to go to the wrong state just so we can visit Colorado? Isn't visiting... and going on a journey more important than stopping criminals? I mean, it's fucking Iowa! Who cares about helping Iowa? Wouldn't you rather go to Colorado than help Iowa? We've got enough fuel. We'll do it. We're gonna be pushing it, but we'll do it. Oh, yep, yeah, okay. So are we gonna, we're gonna be irresponsible. We're gonna be irresponsible. All right, West Virginia to Colorado, we're gonna screw stuff up.
Cowboy, I'm here all dressed in rags. I used to be a tough one and take on great big jags. But I got a homeboy, he's a good one, you all know. Although I haven't seen it for many years ago. But I'm going back to Dixie once more.
Okay, going back to Dixie. Who's the singer? Because that sounds slightly familiar.
When the work's all done this fall. I am a roving cowboy.
Oh, roving cowboy. Roving cowboy.
But I got a homeboy. He's a good one, you all know. Although I haven't seen it. For many years ago.
Cowboys lament, probably.
But I'm going back to Dixie once more.
Slim Critchlow, possibly.
I'm going to see my mother when the work's all.
Oh yeah, I'm going to pay for this, but we're doing it anyway. So what, are we like in Telluride or something?
I'm here all dressed in rags. I used to be a tough
little mountain town.
Take on great big jags. But I got a homeboy, he's a good one, you all
yeah,
know.
Yeah, it's not entirely
although
inaccurate.
I haven't seen it for many years
okay,
ago.
Okay, the quiz thing. Y'all gonna make me do the quiz thing. Make it be about, like, Alfred Packard and the cannibalism and stuff, and I'll get things right.
I'm going to see my mother.
Oh, because we're not in the right location, we can't do the quiz.
I am
well, that's a bummer.
Cowboy, I'm here all dressed in rags. I used to be a tough
okay.
one and take on
oh, they put
bags.
Us in Aspen! Oh, that's cool. Sure.
I haven't seen it
cool. That's fun that they have, like, a location.
Ago.
Darn. Okay, we can't
I'm
do the quiz.
Dixie,
well, that's a shame. So, go to Alaska. girls in Sitka. So that's, see, that's gotta be him. See, there he is again. There's a woman. Tall woman. Short man with black hair. Yeah, that's him. That gotta be him.
How can I help you?
We doing this? Take two? He's a blonde. He's short. He's got glasses. There's nobody else here that looks like this. Are we doing this? Wait, we could ask him, tell me about the suspect and see if he lies.
Let's just say some folks around here seem thick as thieves.
See, he lied. He lied. That helps. See, I'm just like overthinking it. Yeah, blonde, short, average glasses. He got all that. Investigator butt fart for the return of the Field of Dreams.
How dare you defeat my designs? Carmen will hear about this.
I'm so angry at reading the sentence, investigator butt fart.
I was just reading all about your success.
Thank you, Chief.
Your job excellently. The judge says no clemency for Clement C. He'll see nothing but bars for quite a while. But I already have reports of another caper. What do you say? Can you take the case?
Want to do an exploration so that we can go to Colorado? So that I can do the quiz for you guys and get all of them wrong? My little last chunk of brownie, I'm picking up the crumbs with the plate with the rest of the brownie so that I can get maximum brownie edge in my mouth. Explore!
Well, we can all use some downtime to relax and recharge.
If only my boss
is... You might want to do some state hopping in explore mode just to see the sights. Call me when you're ready to take on your next case.
All right. Here you go, butts. Try to do the quizzing. I'm guessing the quiz mode might only be. My family left home when I was a child to head out west all open wide. Sounds John Baez-y. Okay. Yeah, you can't do the quizzes. That's cool. Oh, no, you can't. Here we are. Here we go, buds. Colorado's powerful mountain winds can bring a foot of snow one day, weaving green grass the next. Yeah. The Chinook winds blow out of the Rocky Mountains can roar past 100 miles an hour. This wind can bring drastic climate changes. Cold snowstorms one day, then warm breezes the next, melting all the snow. Yep, Yep, it's very true. Glad that my face is entertaining. Pikes Peak in the Colorado Rockies is so tall, yeah. Beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain. See, I even knew the song. Yep. Yeah, everybody in... Yeah, I knew this from a young age that America the Beautiful was written from. Yeah. When I was a child, niceness. The 13th step leading to the Capitol building in Denver, Colorado. Yeah, that's true. Denver's nickname, the Mile High City, inspired architects to build the 13th step exactly 5280 feet above sea level. Denver's Capitol building is modeled after the National Capitol in Washington, D.C. Yep. See, I'm doing good, y'all. Of course, I just jinxed myself, right? 7-year-old, okay. That sounds like one of those strange but true shits. Probably Mesa Verde. Yep, Mesa Verde. Yep. Yep, cool. Oh, you guys are so nice. Oh, those are fun questions. The song You Take the High Road and I'll Take the Low Road was first sung in Colorado by homesick Scottish immigrants. I don't know. Sure. Although the Scottish thing is a little weird. I'm a little hesitant about that part. Okay. It's the low thing that's weird. Jurassic Park? No. Well, there's lots of dinosaur stuff. I mean, it's not Jurassic Park, but there's a lot of dinosaur stuff around there. You'll find the town of Dinosaur in nearby Dinosaur National Monument. Here you can see over 2,000 dinosaur bones exposed in sandstone walls. Hey, you're ruining your roast streak, though, that way. This all, okay, we already did that one. Spiffy, hey, we kicked buttocks. All right, are there any more quizzy questions? It's a good song that we are listening to. Yeah, we already did that one. Okay, looks like we don't got any more questions. I have no idea, Light. I've got no idea. Okay, so it's all the same questions. Alright, there's another state that we gotta do for a quizzing. Do we need to go to Florida? See what the Florida questions are? Song though. Man, they did good with their loops too. Let's do Florida. Dum, bum, 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 bum. This is not what this song was composed for. Space. So we're in the Kennedy Space Center. All right, you ready for these questions? Nice. Space! Sounds ragtimey. The coastal air in Florida can get so thin that, I know this one. Yeah. Totes falls. Really? Huh. Well, the more you know. Interesting. Florida is known for its hurricanes, ferocious ocean storms that regularly batter the coast. During hurricanes, surrounding air pressure often drops dramatically. In 1926, a storm outside Miami caused a barometric reading so low that some folks reportedly passed out. That's fancy. Huh. Alright, Tampa, Florida is sometimes still subject to pirate attacks. So true-ish. It's probably gonna be like, it's false, but there's a pirate festival or something. Let's just say true. Early in the 19th century, the legendary pirate Jose Gasper terrorized the Florida coast. Tampa today celebrates his audacity during the festival. Yeah, look at that. The city is captured by pirates and the mayor is kidnapped during... beautiful. Beautiful. Sure, they counted it. You good. Alright, the International Worm Fiddling Contest. It does sound like Florida. So we gonna say way? Why not? See, I'm sitting here, I know about tradition with rattlesnakes, rattles in fiddles across the south, but I don't know anything about worms. But it's too weird. Yep, there we go. This contest isn't about making music with worms, it's about trying to catch them. Contestants use metal bars, stakes, and other devices to create vibrations that lure juicy worms to the surface. The best worm fiddler is the one holding the most worms when the fiddling is finished. Beautiful. Flamingos in Florida have swallowing muscles so strong that they can gulp down entire dolphins. What is the matter? Yeah, I'd say false. It sounds false to me too. That's impressive, though. You go, flamingos. All right, we did our Florida questions. Alright, what other states should we go to? So we went to North Carolina already. And they say that's in Chapel Hill. Wonder what questions they got. Because I don't think I did questions when I was there. Roanoke Island disappeared without a trace. They're gonna say true, but of course we've researched more into this. You can tune up for the Tour de Pickle. I've heard of that. There's a bacon-themed bicycle ride in Iowa. Surprised that my family has done this. I have not. My family. Other members of my family have. It's gonna be true. Beautiful. Okay, that's definitely true. Pigs are very big. A North Carolina pig named Big Boy. Yeah, that's a lot of pig. The USA is so weird. I love how weird it is. It's so wonderful. It's a bunch of rural idiots running around being idiots. Yes, this is true. Wait, I didn't read the whole sentence. I read Tar Heel, but I did not read the second half of the sentence. Yeah, no, that's wrong. Yep, read the full sentence. Yes, we did that one. Alright, any more questions? I think we did all the questions. Yep, okay, so we've done all the questions. Alright, next state. Go to South Dakota. Go to Hawaii. Let's see what Hawaii looks like. Go forever. Ooh. So pu'u ha nua o Hanaunau National Historic Park. Honaunau. Cool. Here's Hawaii. I'm just sort of looking at the locations now. We've been to Rhode Island. Where should we go? Wonder where we go in Tennessee. How the music is. Eh! Nashville. Cool. Can't get away from your music history, huh? See if there's any music questions. Small likelihood. Oh, look! No, he's dead. Although there's plenty of conspiracy theories. You may hear claims he's still on tour, but don't believe it. Yeah, they're so nerdy! No, they were not, but this is called the Athens of... Nashville is called the Athens of the South. Ugh. There's a mini Parthenon or whatever. Well, no, it's like a same full-scale replica or something. Yep, it's the ancient Greek. Yep, Nashville is called the Athens of the South because architects built many buildings there imitating ancient Greek designs. Nashville even includes a full replica of the Parthenon Temple. Yep, because you're just weird like that. The United States is so weird. Can't believe how confusing this ended up being. That's false, but it's probably something close that happened. Mules are a common sight. The state celebrates Mule Day in honor of this underappreciated animal, which mule fanciers claim is intelligent, sweet-tempered, and brave, if a bit stubborn. Columbia, Tennessee holds one of the biggest mule markets each year. It's still something that'd be stupid enough to happen. The people of Tennessee love music so much they have 5 official state songs. That's probably pretty true. Blue Moon of Kentucky! Oh, right, it's Kentucky. I'm in Tennessee right now. Rocky Top! Yep, Rocky Top. Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Yep. When it's Iris time, my Tennessee, the Tennessee Waltz. Right, that whole waltz phenomenon craze that happened in the early 40s? Yeah, it had to be early 40s. It's either late 30s or it has to be early 40s. Very early 40s. By the ton? No, you can't buy it by the ton. Yikes. That's... That's by a point of view your answer. Cumberland Gap! Yeah, it's true.
Stealing. Please don't tell on me, Lord, Lord, I'm a steal on back to my house. I'm all you to be. I'm steal on back to my house.
Alright, looks like we are now rotating through questions. Okay, cool. That was fun. Okay, Tennessee. Where else shall I go? Ew, gross. New Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, Virginia. Where should I go? Oh, I'm a fucking nerd. Oh, come on. We went to Montana. Go to Washington or Oregon. Nevada. Or we could do another, one more, actually do an actual freaking thing. Quest. Case! Do another case. I know I've been on here for like 2 hours. I've just been hanging out and enjoying hanging out with people. I guess I needed to dewind and I didn't realize how bad I needed to dewind. I have dewinded, but if people want to just keep on dewinding with me, I will keep dewinding. It is true, it has been 2 whole hours.
Now I'm stealing. Please don't tell on me, Lord, Lord, I'm a steal on back to my same old used to be.
Yeah, it's probably about time to call it quits, you're right.
Same old used to be.
We can call it.
Hope you had a relaxing time off. Are you ready to investigate another crime?
No, we can quit the game. Yeah, it's been a good hangout. Thanks so much for, joining me in this spontaneous weirdness. I need to actually get back to the actual games I actually need to actually stream. Actually. But this was fun to do spontaneously instead. I love you guys so much, and it was so much fun doing this tonight. Again, it's just nice to be able to hang out with friends. So, I love you guys so much, and I hope that you guys all have wonderful nights of doom. I'll probably be on Discord for a little while. I'm not quite ready to sleep. So, yeah, it was wonderful. It was fun. I cannot believe this music thing ended up happening. That ended up being great streaming. All right, anyway, good night, you guys. Bye! Sort of.